very apparent that these robberies are most likely connected and related in some way.
Investigators believe this is the man targeting banks in small Iowa towns. Good evening, everyone. So far, 3 banks in 8 days. Investigators say it's likely that this robber will strike again. The man first robbed a bank in Story County, then Madison, and just this weekend in Greene County. News Channel 8's Angie Hunt has details. It's our top story tonight. Angie?
Well, Kevin, there is no way to predict if or when or what bank this man will hit next. That's why investigators hope you can help to put an end to these robberies before someone gets hurt. Investigators are still processing surveillance video from this bank in Rippey, the latest to be hit in a string of small-town bank robberies. But from what they've seen so far, it's likely related to 2 others in Story and Madison counties.
We have been able to see the video of it, and he was quite open, pointing the weapon at them.
Greene County Sheriff Tom Heater says the man not only robbed the 3 clerks working at the bank, but a customer who was inside at the time. Investigators are now working to compare the video in all 3 cases. This video from the robbery at the Story Bank and Trust in Slater.
It certainly is a brazen act the way this individual is going about the bank robberies.
The man is also careful to cover his entire face. But Story County Captain Barry Thomas is hopeful there are characteristics or features someone will recognize.
Anybody who might have any information on the clothing that they recognize that the individual is wearing, the gait of his walk, anything that might trigger some familiarity.
What you can't see in the video is another similarity in the 3 robberies. The man not only demands money, but the keys to the teller's car.
He's not walking too far. He's taking the teller's car just so that hopefully somebody's not getting a description of what he's driving until he gets a little way out of town.
And that's where he ditches the vehicle. Investigators are not sure if he has another car parked nearby or if he's getting some help, especially getting to the bank.
In the small towns, it would be very obvious if he was walking in, so there is that possibility that he's also connected with another person.
Now, the good news is no one has been hurt in any of these cases, and investigators have been able to recover the stolen vehicles shortly after the robberies. Now, if there's anything you recognize in that video or any information that you have, it might be helpful in the case you are asked to call your local law enforcement agency.
And Angie, as you mentioned at the very top of the story, it's hard to predict when or where this person is going to strike again. So are the banks taking any special precautions to try and fight this guy?
Yeah, because it's hard to predict, not really. But the Greene County Sheriff is encouraging banks in his area to be vigilant, but also to, comply and cooperate with the man's demands if he should strike again.
Sure. All right, Angie, thank you very much.